In this video, we will see how to solve the problem of MSVCR110.dll is missing in just two simple steps. So stay tuned. Hi friends, welcome to our YouTube channel howisolve.com. howisolve.com, a YouTube community helping people to solve everyday tech problems. Hi guys, this is Neil. This error, program cannot start because MSVCR110.dll is missing from your computer. Try reinstalling the program to fix this problem. Has become pretty common in Windows 10 recently, but also affects Windows 8.1 and Windows 7. This error happens usually when you try to use a software which requires Visual C++ redistributable packages for Visual Studio 2012. By default, this particular software package should be installed in your system. However, recently it has been found that certain Windows update packages have either deleted or damaged this particular DLL. The list of software affected by this error is very large, from Adobe After Effects to VAMP Server to several games like Need for Speed and many more. But no problem friends, this error can be fixed very easily. But first, before we continue with this tutorial, we will be requiring your system architecture details, whether your Windows is a 32-bit system or a 64-bit. If you don't know the architecture, continue viewing this video. I'll show you the step required for the same. If you already know, you can click the skip button that you can see on the left side of the screen. To know your system architecture, in Windows 7 to open command prompt in admin mode, click the start CMD. Right click, click run as administrator. A UAC will pop up, click it up. Yes. In Windows 10, to open command prompt in admin mode, right click the start button and select command prompt admin. In Windows 8, to open command prompt in admin mode, from the start screen type CMD. Right click and select run as administrator. If a UAC pops up, click on yes. In the command prompt, type the command WMIC space OS space GET get space OS architecture ARCHITECTURE. Hit enter. The output of the command would indicate your OS architecture. If it is a 32-bit system, it would say 32-bit. If it's a 64-bit system, it would show 64-bit. After that, once you know your system architecture, we can proceed with step 1 of this tutorial, downloading Visual C++ redistributable packages for Visual Studio 2012. The download link is in the video description. On clicking on the link, this page should open. On scrolling down, you will see this download option. Click the download button and then on this page, it will indicate that there are three files that you can choose to download. So if you have got a 32-bit system, you just have to choose VC redistribution x86.exe, this one. But if you have got a 64-bit system, you have to select both the x86 version as well as the 64-bit version. So we'll check both of them since my system is 64-bit, and then we'll click on next. After that, you should have the two packages downloaded in your downloads folder. If you are on 32-bit system, then you'll require just one. So I'll cancel this since I've already downloaded them. Now let's head to step 2, installing Visual C++ redistributable packages. On clicking the package, you'll either be shown a screen where it will ask you to install this package like it is being shown here, or you might be shown a screen where it will ask you to repair the package. The steps for installation is pretty simple. Just click on I agree and click install. Again, a UAC will ask you for your confirmation. Click it on yes, and then it will start the process of installation. Okay, now the setup has finished. We'll do the same for the x86. Since in my system I already have this package installed, it will show me where either I want to uninstall it or repair it. We have to click on repair. This will ensure that if some files are corrupted in this package, it will replace them with the original copy. We'll click on repair. Again, a UAC will come, then click it. Yes. Okay. Now, since this package has also been installed, click You can click close. After this, your software should work properly without giving you this error message. And if it is not working properly, then you have to reinstall the software, uninstall it and then reinstall the software. And after installing it again, it should not show this error message. Hit the like button if your problem was solved. If not, hit the dislike button. If this video helped you, please be part of this community. Join us in the goal of helping people with their everyday tech problems. Share this video to forums where you have visited in search of solving this problem. Join our community by subscribing to our channel. We love to hear your feedback and experiences. Share it in the comment section. Thanks for watching, guys. See you later. Bye.